Did you know that there's a way to use your iPad as a second or third display for your Mac? Use macOS apps on your iPad, use the Apple Pencil, and best of all, it's included and free. It's called Sidecar, and it's a feature that I use every day to help drastically improve my productivity when I'm using my MacBook, my Mac Mini, or my iMac. I'm gonna tell you why I use Sidecar, show you how to set it up, and then we'll look at the different features and some limitations. My main workstation over there has 6 monitors. Well, technically 7. And personally, I've always found multiple displays to really improve my productivity because I don't have to minimize and maximize windows when I'm working with multiple apps. So maybe I'm doing research and I'm referencing multiple articles, or I'm doing development and I need to code, do graphic design, and test at the same time, or doing some video editing and I want my timeline and effects window in one monitor, and then I want to have different B-roll bins in different monitors. In all of those cases, I found that having multiple monitors just speeds up my workflow. What's great about Sidecar is that it gives me a super easy way to connect an additional display to my Macs, and I can do it wirelessly or tethered. This is super convenient because when I'm on the go or if I'm traveling with my MacBook, I always have my iPad Pro with me. All I need is a little stand or a case from my iPad Pro accessories video, or even the magic keyboard. Like really, I just need something to prop up the iPad, and then I'm ready to go and I have a secondary display anywhere I am. When I'm at home, I usually have my MacBook or the Mac Mini connected to an ultra wide display, so the iPad is now a second or third display. With my iMac, I don't like to mount a second monitor because I like how clean that setup is, so I can just grab any of my iPads and I'm all set. Now let's get to how you start a Sidecar session, and it couldn't be easier. If you're using Big Sur or Monterey, just click on the control center icon. Then display, you'll see an option for connect to, and it will list any iPad that it detects. Just click on the iPad you want to connect to and you're all set. You'll see the iPad display flicker once, and now you have an additional desktop display. There are a few important settings that I want to cover before we start using Sidecar. So go ahead and click on control center and then display. You can change some of the settings here, but for your initial setup, you should click on Sidecar settings. Here you can choose whether you want to show the sidebar, and if so, whether you want it on the left or the right side of the iPad. You can also choose whether you want the touch bar, and in case you do, whether you want it at the bottom or the top. Finally, if you plan on using an Apple Pencil which has double tap functionality, you can enable it. From here, you can hit the back arrow and then click on displays to go to display preferences. Or if you close the window by mistake, click on control center, display, and display preferences. You'll see every attached display, and you can drag the iPad display to reflect where it is in real life. So for example, if it's on the right of your MacBook, you're gonna wanna show it on the right. If it's on the left, you're gonna want it on the left. That makes it easier for you to drag and drop windows and to use the trackpad or mouse. For the most part, you'll want to use the iPad as an extended display. But if you want to change that functionality and instead mirror your display, you can click on display settings, select the sidecar display, and then choose use as mirror display. Now let's look at the sidecar controls on the sidebar. Starting at the top, the first button shows or hides the menu bar when you're viewing a window in full screen on the iPad. The next button moves the Mac's dock to the iPad and then back to the Mac. The next 4 keys are modifier keys. So we have Command, Option, Control, and Shift. You can tap and hold each one to use them, or double tap to lock them. Next, we have a very useful undo button, which you could use in any app that supports it. Then we have a button that shows or hides the on-screen keyboard in case you're away from your main keyboard. Then finally, the last button is used to disconnect the iPad and end your sidecar session. You'll also notice that you have touch bar controls at the bottom, which will change depending on which app you're using. Now that we have Sidecar up and running and we understand the controls, how do we actually get an app from the Mac onto the iPad? We can take an open window and drag it over, or we can hover over the green dot. And now, along with the options to enter full screen, tile window to the left and to the right, you'll see move to and then the name of your iPad. You can also arrange the windows on the iPad just like you would on the Mac. So if you hover over the green button, you can tile the window to the right or to the left and then open another app on the other side. And of course, you can use this method to send the window back to the Mac display. Now, as far as input devices, you can use the keyboard, mouse, or trackpad. They work perfectly on both devices, and I like that the cursor remains an arrow on the iPad, unlike the circle that we get with mouse control in iPadOS. One thing to remember is that Sidecar is running as an app on your iPad. So if you want to use another iPad app without disconnecting, just swipe up. You'll see Sidecar is now in your dock, and you can open and use any other iPad app. When you're finished, just tap the Sidecar app on your dock and you can continue your session. I've used Sidecar with a lot of productivity apps, different browsers, and even Photoshop, Lightroom, and a couple of video editing apps. And for what I need, it's worked great. I've also used it as a secondary display to watch content on while I'm doing work, and let's take a look at a couple of different use cases to see if there's any lag. Starting off, let's drag a window from the MacBook to the iPad Pro and shake it around to see if there's any kind of latency. In my opinion, this is really smooth, and remember that we're working wirelessly here. Next, let's play a video. Again, there is no lag and the audio is perfectly synced. Using the Apple Pencil with Photoshop for editing photos on the iPad works great. If you're drawing or making faster movements, you will see that there is some lag. For how I use it, which is mostly for photo editing and then for some light drawing, this hasn't been an issue. I also like the fact that I can pinch to zoom with my finger and then continue to work. If you're primarily looking to draw and you use pressure sensitive brushes, it is doable, but you get a better user experience when you're drawing directly on the iPad without Sidecar. When editing video, there is no lag when scrubbing the timeline or during playback. And it's nice to always have a second or third display to work with. Before I get to some opportunities for improvement, if you've gotten value from this video, give it a thumbs up. It lets me know what content you like so that I can make more of it. And I still see that over 90% of you are new viewers, so hit that subscribe button. Now I want to talk about some opportunities for improvement with Sidecar. And for me, there really weren't many. Starting out, touch functionality doesn't extend to macOS. So you can't interact with the menus or select tools and options from the apps using your finger. You can use the Apple Pencil, which is actually more precise. And since the UI isn't designed for touch, if you try to use your finger, you might miss what you're trying to select, but I'd still like to have the option. Next, when you're browsing the web or when you're using different apps, you can use two fingers to scroll. But then again, you can't click on a link, button, or any other element in a web page, which requires you to go back to either the Apple Pencil, the trackpad, or the mouse. Scrolling is also not elastic in most cases, like it is when using the trackpad. So it stops as soon as your fingers leave the display. With the trackpad, or when you're using the iPad directly without Sidecar, the page continues to scroll for a bit as if it has momentum. As far as connectivity, I haven't had any issues at all with Sidecar, and it worked great for me with every iPad that I tried. Speaking of that, let me quickly cover compatible devices and some requirements. Here's a list of compatible Macs, and as far as iPads, all the iPad Pro models will work, 6th generation iPad Pro or newer, 5th generation iPad mini or newer, and then 3rd generation iPad Air or newer. You also need to be using macOS Catalina or later, and then iPadOS 13 or later. Your Mac and iPad need to be signed into iCloud with the same Apple ID, which they probably are. And if you're using Sidecar wirelessly, you need to have the devices within 30 feet or 10 meters of each other and have Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and handoff turned on. You also need to make sure that the iPad isn't sharing its cellular connection and that the Mac is not sharing its internet connection. If you want to use Sidecar in wired mode, just use a USB-C or Lightning cable, then make sure that the iPad is set to trust your Mac. Hopefully this video was helpful. Click on my face to subscribe and then watch one of these videos. You know what I always say? Buy it nice or buy it twice. Good luck and see you soon.